All right, let's move on to some phrasal verbs that use the preposition on. Hi, I'm Josh, your American English guide. This lesson is based on the previous lesson, so if you're new here, I highly recommend that you watch that lesson first. As we know, the logic of the preposition on is always a positive or active state, and it is usually also a surface or a platform. Like last time, we will look at some examples and then see how the logic applies to each one. Let's jump in. These are the example sentences for phrasal verbs that we will be looking at in today's video. The preposition on is used in a lot of phrasal verbs. You might know some or all of these examples, but that doesn't matter. Our purpose here isn't to learn the phrasal verbs, it's to get a better feeling for the preposition and see how the logic actually applies by working with a verb to create a new meaning. This will help you learn any phrasal verb much faster and more easily. Let's look at the first example. If you're talking about a topic and you want to change the topic to something else, you can move on to another topic. Remember that a topic is like a special platform. If you move on to another topic, you leave the first platform and go to the new platform, like you're physically moving from one place to another. Now, this new platform is the positive or active state, and the old topic or platform is a negative or inactive state. In this context, the meaning of the verb to move is putting the logic of the preposition on into action. This gives the feeling of moving forward to the next topic or discussion point. Next we have, I'm counting on you. To count on someone or something means to rely on someone or something, or to depend on someone or something. However, rely on and depend on aren't phrasal verbs. They're simply two verbs that naturally use the preposition on. The reason why count on is a phrasal verb is because the basic meaning of to count is changing when we add the preposition on. We're not talking about actually counting something like numbers. Instead, it means that I need something to happen or I need someone to do something for me. If it doesn't happen, then something bad will happen. With all three of these verbs, you're putting some kind of weight on someone or something. The person or thing that you're counting on becomes an abstract surface or platform that supports you. This is very clear with depend on. For example, he depends on his family. Clearly, his family is his support, so he places his weight on them. The example sentence, I'm counting on you, means that I'm putting my weight on you because I'm trusting that you will do something for me. Now, notice something very interesting. We have idioms and phrases that make this point even stronger. Stand on your own two feet, meaning don't rely on anyone for help or support. We can express the same idea with the phrase, don't lean on anyone. And also, he carries the weight of the world on his shoulders. Our next example, I have to cut back on junk food. Here, the topic is junk food. In this sentence, the person is eating more junk food than they think is acceptable, so they either want to or have to eat less of it. And that is what cut back means, to reduce the amount of something. Now, our focus here isn't on cut back, so we won't worry about how that works. But why do we use on after cut back? Most resources will tell you that this is a two-part phrasal verb. However, it is not. On is a connector between cut back and junk food. Usually, prepositions like of or to are connectors between phrasal verbs and their objects. In this case, the preposition on is being used, which is less common. But there's a reason, which is the logic of the preposition on. This actually works exactly the same way as saying this book is on Gandhi. the context and application is a little bit different, but it should be easy to see that the same basic type of expression or surface meaning is being used. Next, I saw him getting on the bus. In this context, to get on the bus means to board the bus. If we apply the logic of the preposition on, we can see that he's getting onto the platform. That's pretty easy. Next we have, hang on or hold on while I grab my coat. Now in this sentence, both hang on and hold on mean to wait for a moment. Let's say that you are leaving the house, so you're in the process of an action, leaving. But your friend wants to grab his coat so he can wear it because it's cold outside. So he asks you to wait for a moment. The action, leaving, is now in a negative state because you temporarily stopped leaving, and the new action, waiting, is in a positive or active state. So the action to hang is on, exactly like the light is on. More specifically, think of this like a traffic light. There's a red light which tells you to stop. There's a green light which tells you to go. If the red light is on, it's active, meaning the green light is inactive. Similarly, if the green light is on, it is active, meaning the red light is inactive. When your friend grabs his coat and joins you, you both leave. This means that the action to hang, the red light, is now off because you stopped the waiting, and the action to leave is on again because you started leaving again. I hate people who look down on others. If you look down on others, it means that you think you are superior or better than other people. This means that in your mind, you see yourself in a higher position. It's easy to imagine this higher position as a platform, like a stage. Interestingly, we have a phrase, to put someone on a pedestal. When we put someone on a pedestal, we're not literally putting them on a pedestal. It's like that person is so good and amazing that they can't do anything wrong. If you look down on other people, then it means that you kind of put yourself on a pedestal because you think that you're better than them. So it's completely logical to say that you look down on them. It's very similar to count on or depend on because you are putting your gaze, your look, on that person and it has some weight. Because in this case, you are judging them. Notice that we have the phrase, the weight of his gaze on me. There are a couple other ways to say this sentence. Very simply, of course, you can say, I hate people who think that they're better than others. But notice this other alternative. I hate people who think that they're all high and mighty. So the logic of the preposition on is actually still working in the background. Our next example, I'm going to try on these pants. This is similar to the phrasal verb put on when talking about clothing. Try on is almost the same thing. The difference is that you put the clothes on in order to see if they fit and if you like the way they look. So it's put on plus the idea of try. Everything about wearing clothes that we talked about in the last video also applies here. And now we have, come on, we're going to be late. The logic of how the phrasal verb come on works is similar to the logic of move on, but the surface meaning is very different. If the speaker is already going somewhere or wants to start going somewhere, but the listener isn't ready or is moving too slowly, then come on means that the speaker wants the listener to hurry. Notice that this meaning of come on is also a positive state or active state because you are in the process of going somewhere or moving faster than someone. You can also think of ready as an abstract platform that works like a green light, similar to what we saw earlier. So the speaker is already on an abstract platform that we can call ready. or a platform that we can call moving faster than the listener, depending on the context. The listener is not on this platform yet, and the speaker wants him or her to move faster and join the speaker on the platform so they can get to their destination faster. If you aren't starting to build a feeling for the preposition on yet, that's perfectly normal. Remember, the logic is connected under the surface. So as we learn the logic of more prepositions, you will start to feel previous prepositions even more. Ready to see how the logic works in some idioms? Click this video and I'll see you there. Thanks for watching.